Hi everyone, let's talk about checkbox in this video. And checkbox has a little different case because there can be a single checkbox to accept terms and condition, to agree on terms, and there may be a multiple checkbox as a checkbox group, right? So checkbox mostly captures the value as a flag response, right? Or sometimes when you have a checkbox group, you wanted to capture the value which particular checkbox you have selected, same as radio button. And sometimes you have only single checkbox to see that user has accepted the terms and condition in the bottom of the form, right? So how to do that? So for that, let's write something in the signup form. Here we will have initial values. So we are just going to write initial values will have a two properties. Like first is a toggle property, which we are initializing it as a false. And there is one more property which is checked which particular checkbox from the checkbox group you have selected. And I have onSubmit. Okay, onSubmit method, I can just write a async of it I can use here. I have values. So we have already talked about that you can use async of it. And I just have a sleep of 500 milliseconds, and then I am just console.log values, or you can actually set form submitting as false. I mean, we can skip that. So this is a formic tag, and there are many ways to write a formic component, right? Either you use this render function. This is the one way. Here you access the props and write your component and you render something. Okay, sorry, let return something. This is the one way, right? Here we are using the children component. So you can also write everything as a child. And here we are accessing values from it. And here we are returning our form. Either you can just wrap it around return. These brackets are sometimes unnecessary. So in this return, we can write our form tag. Okay, form will have a field. Okay, there can be a multiple field which we wanted to have. So first field is checkbox. So field type, so you can say input type checkbox, right? So same way input type radio, input type checkbox. So field type is checkbox. And name property is important because name we are passing as a toggle, the first property, right? Similarly, you can put error message, and whenever the value is selected, what you will print, you will be able to get, if I just try to print it, what values you will get. So I will be able to get values.toggle property, which should be either true or false. Okay, this is just to print the boolean value. Okay. Apart from that, there will be a checkbox group, right? So this is a single checkbox which has a name property toggle. But what if I wanted to have a checkbox as a checkbox group? Because checkbox, there you can select many checkbox. It's not like radio button where you can select only one options. Other option will get disabled after that. So this is a little important. Here I can set the value, name will be same, name I have checked, so name will be same everywhere. And name, and then there is another property, what value they hold, right? Value, consider I have 1, 2, 3. So you can change these values to 2, 3, 4, or 5. Okay, these are the values I have. So the difference here between the radio button and a checkbox, it's kind of same. Input type radio we were writing, here input type checkbox. And the name property needs to be same because you are writing checkbox as a group, not individual checkbox. But it doesn't mean that you can't check multiple checkbox. I mean, this is how they are designed natively in the browser. Okay, So here we are just setting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can put a label also with these forms, like which one is getting selected. Okay. So whenever you select multiple checkbox, these values will be added in the checked array. Right. So this is the difference here. In the input type radio, we were selecting only one value, but in checkbox group, you can just put checkbox group that this is a checkbox group and every checkbox has some labels. But whenever you keep selecting 1, 2, 3, then these values will get added in this checkbox array, right? So whatever the form you are writing where you have option that user can select multiple checkbox, in that case, you can actually write this kind of code. Okay. So this is also plain and simple. So we have done all these three different type of forms, input type having radio buttons, input type having checkbox, input type having select, an input type having text, passwords, email, we have already covered. So now we are familiar with all these different form components. Others are like date picker, file chooser, all are kind of same. Okay. So now I think now we are on the clear path to just write a common renderer function, and based on the type, we will render either checkbox, radio button, field, email, and all.